In the vast landscape of music, each individual genre has found itself to repeat themes throughout the numerous bands and singers it holds. For example, punk rock has always held a theme of anarchy and rebellion. Classic rock has always upheld somber ideas with an overall uplifting message. And hip-hop, or at least a vast majority of it, has had themes of luxury and pleasure. But in every genre of music, there's always an experimental side. How far can you push the genre's sound before it becomes unenjoyable? And for hip-hop, we have Death Grips, an experimental rap group with a sound that shows many influences but still manages to sound unique. It's certainly no secret Death Grips aims to be different. From their uncanny visuals to their strange taste in beats and sounds, this group screams experimental, which is a big part of their main appeal. Death Grips' music and visuals almost look satirical in nature, looking like something that came off r/cursedimages' subreddit. But this is a real band, and they aim to push rap's sound, starting with what the sound they use themselves. Notice the deep, muddy bassiness of it all, with hard-to-describe high-pitched noises contrasting the overall heaviness of it. The way these combine with each other assaults your attention unlike any other hip-hop song. Death Grips already starts off the bat with completely different noises than hip-hop, almost in the realms of metal. Pushing along the themes of this unsettling and loud sound, MC Ride, who is the main singer, screams at the top of his lungs in every single track he makes. On first impression, Death Grips aims to sock you in the face with their music, and the more and more listens you give the track, the more you actually grow into it. Because once you start to get past the overall loudness of the track, you actually start to decode what MC Ride is actually saying. Now, the lyrics in a Death Grips song can be cryptic, nonsensical, or dare I say, intelligent, depending on how far you take the abstract value of the song. At first, MC Ride screams nonsense, saying things like breaking into an Apple store, or a subatomic penetration firing through your skull. But if you look deeper, you'll find almost philosophical quotes like, "My existence is a momentary lapse of reason." That's a very wordy sentence to say in a rap song, and if it has any deeper meaning, then the lyricist could be making a callback to Pink Floyd's studio album, A Momentary Lapse of Reason, which was controversial for being a more hated Pink Floyd album. Now, many critics would argue Death Grips doesn't have any higher meaning, and each nonsensical lyric is just that, nonsensical. But another example of MC Ride actually delivering decent commentary is his criticism on consumerist society. In the same song, he says, "A plethora of maniacs and spiral stairs make your water break in the Apple store." MC Ride is trying to claim that the plethora of maniacs are the crazed consumers of corporate products. So crazy they will basically give birth in an Apple store, which is an exaggerated meaning, but still underlines the crazy lengths people will go to just to get the latest product. Now, these tidbits are taken from the song Hacker, and there are even more numerous themes writhing throughout this loud piece of music that you really have to look out for. But the meaning of Death Grips can go in two ways. One, they're really just a nonsensical band, and aim to only see how far they can push the sound of hip-hop before people really start to genuinely hate it. Or two, they not only want to push the boundaries of hip-hop, but they also want to convey a message behind their cryptic and confusing lyrics. Like them or hate them, we need bands like Death Grips in every genre, to not only push the musicality of each genre, but to also smartly keep messages and lyrics without being too preachy. This is Sprite Cranberry. Thanks for watching. It's so low.